Welcome back to NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman. We're here at the United States Department of Agriculture, and with me now is U.S. Secretary of Agriculture, Sonny Perdue. Mr. Secretary, thank you so much for giving us some time today.
Glad to visit with you, Kevin.
You know, about a month ago, the USDA and FDA mm-hmm. hosted a joint meeting talking about who should have jurisdiction over this lab-grown fake meat. Now,
certainly.
NCBA believes fervently that it should reside right here at the United States Department of Agriculture.
Right.
Why do you believe you're the best agency to regulate these products?
Well, again, I think probably in this food safety environment in which we're in, I think a single food safety agency government-wide would be the best example because of the conflict in the dual jurisdiction. And we're probably going to get in some dual jurisdiction here over the cultivation of the stem cells initially. FDA does that in humans and others, and there's a role for them. But when it becomes stem cells growing into a product that's going to be consumed, we want the same standards that we have in our traditional beef to be over the cell culture protein to be examined in the same way.
And we're pleased to hear about that. You know, about a year and a half ago, you stood side by side with our president, Craig Yudin, in mm-hmm. Beijing, China, celebrating the reopening
yes.
of the Chinese market for U.S. beef, which created a lot of excitement across
yes,
the beef industry. Given the current trade tensions with China, what are the prospects for U.S. beef producers being able to capitalize on that opportunity?
Well, obviously, our beef has gotten overtaken by the trade disruptions that affect everything, but I got a good reception initially, and I expect our U.S. beef to enjoy a great market share in China as soon as we can resolve these trade disputes that we currently have with China. And really, the ball's in China's court. We just simply ask them to play by the rules, play fair, that all countries abide by in international trade, stop stealing our stuff, and play fair.
That's understandable. You know, the good news is for the U.S. beef industry, we're on pace to perhaps break some records, both in terms of value and volume of U.S. beef exports this year. But there are some concerns beyond China, particularly as it relates to Japan and other countries. What is the Trump administration doing to make certain that this positive momentum in exports continues for U.S. beef producers?
Well, certainly you mentioned Japan, a great consumer and customer of our beef industry. And I'm very happy to hear the announcement that we're going to re-enter a bilateral with Japan probably the first of the year after the notification to Congress. And we're expecting big things there. I think Japanese love our product, and we hope to become even a better customer there, as well as trying to move with the EU over the whole hormone issue on the WTO quota that we were given. We're hopefully closer to resolution about that.
That would be really good news.
Yeah.
You know better than I the disasters that many of our producers have faced this year, from the droughts to the terrible hurricanes down
right.
in your neck of the woods, and now these wildfires that are
right.
ravaging across California. What kind of disaster assistance is available for producers right now, and do you anticipate any additional disaster assistance from those affected?
Well, you're aware, obviously, the 2017 issues and Congress giving the supplemental disaster appropriation there. We call it the WHIP program. Many of your listeners have already applied for that, some that were affected by the wildfires and some that were affected by the hurricane issues there, the wildfire hurricane indemnity program.
Mm-hmm.
And on top of the regular safety nets, we have a livestock indemnity program, and those, that was a supplemental. Certainly in 2018, we hoped that we wouldn't see those kind of disasters again, but you mentioned Hurricane Florence and Hurricane Michael, as well as the wildfires that we're seeing across our land, not just in Oklahoma, as well as California and those. And I do hope that Congress will look again and give us expanded authorities to include the 2018 disasters into the indemnity program of disaster.
And speaking of Congress, today begins the lame duck session of
yeah.
Congress.
Yeah.
I know I join many people in rural America a little frustrated that we don't yet have a farm bill. What is your prognostication relative to our ability to get a farm bill during this lame duck, and what's your message to Congress?
I think many members, including Chairman Conaway and Chairman Roberts, are frustrated as well that we don't have a farm bill. Many people know the issues. Most of the issues dealt with something that farmers don't deal with, and that's supplemental nutrition program and work requirements there. I think we will get a farm bill. I think we'll get a farm bill prior to Christmas, And again, so our farmers can plan for their programs and program crops going into 2019 in time. I think it'll be an evolutionary bill more so than revolutionary. And the safety net there that has been there with crop insurance and other programs, the ARC and PLC programs, I think you'll see sustained. So by and large, it's going to be an evolutionary program. I think you'll see a coming together after this election of people that want to get a farm bill.
Is there anything our members and viewers can do to support that?
Well, again, I think probably they already have and indicated to their members in their own districts there of their desire, and I think that's condemned. Democracy depends upon communication and engagement.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. Okay. Thank you so much for your time, and I want to say a special thank you for joining the FFA at the National FFA Convention. My three kids thoroughly enjoyed you and President Trump's remarks. And I want to thank you for your support of the next generation of agriculturalists.
Absolutely. So important. These young kids, if you get down on America, just go to an FFA convention and you'll get inspired again.
I couldn't agree more. Thank you, Mr. Secretary.
Thank you. Thanks.
Once again, our thanks to Secretary Perdue for taking time to visit with us earlier today. Every day, the NCBA staff is working with USDA and other agencies on the issues that matter to cattle-producing families. You can help support this important work by joining in the fight for our industry's future by becoming an NCBA member. Just call 1-866-233-3872, or you can visit the website joinncba.org.